The third question is basically about seeds. We had done our video based on wheat or barley, and some of you have been asking about barley and saying it's not available in your countries. So today we would like to show you some of the seeds that you can use and basically what most livestock need. Okay, most livestock in terms of crude protein have a certain range of protein that they need, which is between 15% to 25%. Now, this being the recommended range, we know that if you fall below 15, then here you have less production. And if you give your livestock more than 25%, again, you have less production. The excess proteins are not absorbed in the body. They are excreted through urine. So it is best to know that most livestock do not need crude protein above 25%. If you feed above 25% thinking that you'll get more production, what you actually get is less. So of the seeds that we have here, we have soya, which has a crude protein of 45%. Again, these are data that we have collected from the lab. So we acknowledge that some of these results might be different depending on the way you carry your analysis, the method which you use. But we are talking from our experience. So soya is 45%. Then the barley seeds, after growing hydroponically, have a 23% crude protein. For wheat, it's 19%. For oats, it's 21%. For sorghum, it's 12%. For maize or corn, 6%. Millet has 11%. So, knowing that most people cannot access either barley, wheat, or oats, it is best if you have different options. And today we are going to pursue three options which you can use to understand how you can mix some of these seeds or hydroponic fodder grown from the seeds that might be locally available for you, and how you can use the Pearson square to mix two seeds so that you achieve what you need. So basically you will need to grow the, say if it's sorghum, you will need to grow sorghum separately, and then say if it's millet, you'll need to grow it separately. So today we are going to look at three scenarios. First, we are going to look at sorghum and maize. Then we are going to look at maize and millet. Then we are going to look at sorghum and millet. And then we are going to see, after growing hydroponic fodder, how many parts of each will you need. So the most important thing is, after you check on this, you need to place the percentages of the different cereals. So for sorghum, it's 12%. For maize, it's 6%. So we can start with this one here. The way the calculation on the Pearson square is done is you use the largest number along the diagonal to get the result here. So in this case, between 12 and 20, 20 minus 12, you subtract 12 from 20, you get 8 parts. Okay? I'm gonna put this away first. So you get 8 parts, and 20 minus 6, or 6 subtracted from 20, is 14 parts. So this, for you to use sorghum fodder and maize fodder, you'll need 14 parts of sorghum and 8 parts of maize. That's how you do it. So in this case, we have maize and millet. So this one is 6%. This is 11%. So it will be, you subtract 11 from 20, it will be 9 parts. 9 parts of maize. And then you subtract 6 from 20, you get 14 parts of millet. So in this case, if you had sorghum, if you have sorghum here, so sorghum is 12%, millet is 11%. So it is to say 20 minus 12 is 8 parts of millet, and 20 minus 11 is 9 parts of sorghum. I have just I have just decided to take examples of these because in Africa, most people write to us and say that they have access to maize, millet, and sorghum. So depending on what cereal is available to you and the costs which you have to undergo to acquire it, we would like to introduce you to Pearson Square. Yeah. So basically, that's how you can use some of these cereals to get the desired result. So for example, all your livestock need 100 kgs of hydroponic fodder. 100 kgs. So when you have, say, this on your table, and you're saying you need 9 parts of maize and 14 parts of millet. So what you're going to do is to know that for you to produce maize, you need 9 parts out of 9 plus 14 is 23 times 100 kgs. Okay? And then for millet, how many kgs you need to produce to be able to feed your livestock is basically 14 parts out of 23, which is the whole, multiply by 100 kgs in order to know how many kilos of millet and how many kilos of maize you need to produce. So from my small calculator, so this one will need 39 kgs. And of course, this one will need 61 kgs. So basically, I just hope you're not confused by all these multiplication signs, but I'm sure by now you see. So after you get this, then you need now to come to this 9 out of 9 plus 14, which is 23, multiply by 100, you get 39 kgs. And then for millet, you do the same, and you're able to calculate. As simple as that.